I'm a tiny tiger in a brave new world, gonna free this town. If you didn't know about me already, well, you know it now.
Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Objectivist Girl, if you haven't met me already. And that was my new song, Shrug. Hopefully that's going to be an Atlas Shrugs Part 3, the movie. And behind me, you'll see the Free State Project flag. I'm broadcasting from the Free State Project headquarters in New Hampshire. If you'd like to learn more information about the Free State Project, please see the link below. So normally in week two, I would spend time talking about a competing philosophy. So I thought it would be fitting to talk about Ayn Rand's views on libertarianism because it is such a common conversation that libertarians have with objectivists within the movement that Ayn Rand didn't like the libertarian philosophy. This is not entirely true, but it does have some truth to it. So Ayn Rand's philosophy, objectivism, is built on a foundation of reality and knowledge theories. Libertarianism is actually a political philosophy. So objectivism is a personal philosophy with a political theory. And Ayn Rand took a large issue with libertarians' views not being grounded in a strict adherence to philosophy. And this was her main issue with libertarianism. So this lack of grounding has actually caused different philosophical views within the libertarian community, such as voluntarianism, anarchism, etc. And these views, Ayn Rand believed, were not grounded in a strict adherence to philosophy and could not thrive in the American culture because she believed that a philosophical renaissance was necessary. So that would require a very strict adherence to theories built on the hierarchy I presented in my last video. And now I'm going to talk to you a little bit about what issues Ayn Rand had with specific philosophies within the libertarian movement. Ayn Rand makes her views on anarchism extremely clear. To the anarchist, she says, free market functions by the choice of the people involved. She says this in her essay, The Nature of Government, From the Virtue of Selfishness. She notes that free choices are choices made when free from force, and that it is impossible to have free market competition for the provision of the protection that frees one from force in the first place. So ultimately, anarchism will result in a civil war. Skeptical libertarians deny the possibility of knowing anything with absolute certainty. Ayn Rand grounded her philosophy in the fact that knowledge is knowable. So this didn't jive with her philosophy very well. Religious libertarians appeal to their faith in God in order to support their beliefs. Ayn Rand grounded her atheism in the fact that existence exists, so this was axiomatic to her philosophy. She stated, objectivism advocates reason as man's sole means of knowledge, and therefore, for the reasons I've already given, it is atheist. It denies any supernatural dimensions presented as a contradiction of nature of existence. This applies not only to God, but also to every variant of the supernatural ever advocated or to be advocated. In other words, we accept reality, and that is all. Utilitarian libertarians believe that efficiency, economic efficiency, and the good of the society is a justification for libertarianism. Ayn Rand believed that there needed to be no justification for freedom because man is an ends in and of himself, which I'm going to discuss later on. It's a very important foundational concept of her philosophy. In basic terms, this means that no man has a right to another man's life, no justification needed. Hedonist libertarians believe that libertarianism is good because it allows us to do what we want. Ayn Rand believed that even though freedom allows us to do what we want, we have a moral obligation to right decisions. So as you can see, all of these philosophies deviate from Ayn Rand's views in her philosophy. So that's why she didn't call herself a libertarian. So the question for the day is, what does libertarianism mean to you? What does it mean to you to be a libertarian? And so leave that in the comment section below. Again, I always look forward to hearing from my viewers. And of course, below, I've included links to my Facebook, Twitter, website, and music, so you can check out the rest of my song, Shrug, which will hopefully be in Atlas Shrugged Part 3, the movie. And thank you for visiting my channel. I really hope you've enjoyed this video and you've learned a lot. And always remember that knowledge is not for all men, but for those who seek it. So keep seeking.